गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ माई थर्ड क्लास ऑन रियल नंबर। हेयर वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू टॉपिक, फंडामेंटल थियोरम ऑफ अर्थमेटिक। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विथ फंडामेंटल थियोरम ऑफ अर्थमेटिक, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस द कंपोजिट नंबर एंड प्राइम नंबर। दो यू ऑल आर अवेयर ऑफ कंपोजिट नंबर एंड प्राइम नंबर, but I am just reminding it that what is a composite number. A number is said to be composite if it has more than two factors. The smallest composite number is 4, because it has three factors, 1, 2, and 4. And prime number, a number which has two and only two factors, is called a prime number. The smallest prime number is 2. It has two factors, 1 and 2. Now, what is fundamental theorem of arithmetic? Every composite number can be expressed as a product of primes, and this factorization is unique except for the order in which the prime factor occurs. The example is given for you. We are having 12. Its prime factors are 2 and 3. Its prime factorization will be equals to 2 into 2 into 3. Now, same 12 can be expressed in another way of prime factorization. It is 12 is equal to 2 into 3 into 2. Here order has been changed. Here in the beginning 2 2's were there and then 1 3, and here order has been changed. But result remains same, it is giving the same number 12. So it's called unique prime factorization. Every composite number has its own unique prime factorization. Similarly, this 12 has again expressed in another way, 3 into 2 into 2. These are the three kinds of factorization, but all factorizations are giving 12 only. So it is the uniqueness of the composite number that it is always expressed as the product of prime factors. Here few more expressions of a composite number as product of its prime factors. The first number is 140. It has been expressed as 2 into 2 into 5 into 7. And another number, it is 7429, which has been expressed as product of 17, 19 and 23. Here now we are going to discuss how to find LCM and HCF using prime factorization method. Now we have understood that how to find out the prime factorization. Now we will learn how to find HCF and LCM using prime factorization. Here the numbers are 8 and 30. We have to find HCF and LCM of 8 and 30. For that we will find out the prime factorization of both 8 and 30. 8 can be expressed as 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 2 to the power 3. And 30 is equal to 2 to the power 1 into 3 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1. Now, HCF of 8 and 30 is equal to 2 to the power 1. How this 2 to the power 1 has come? Because it is the rule for finding HCF in case of prime factorization that the product of the smallest power of each common prime factor in the given number. When we will find the common factor, we see that 2 is the only common factor over there, and the smallest power is 1. Therefore, HCF of 8 and 30 is equals to 2 to the power 1, which will give you the result 2. Now come LCM. LCM of 8 and 30 is equals to 2 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1, 2 to the power 3 resulting in 8, 3 to the power 1 resulting in 3, and 5 to the power 1 resulting in 5, and the product of all these 3 is equals to 120. Now it is the rule to find the LCM in case of prime factorization that the product of the highest power of each prime factor which are available in the given numbers. If you will see the prime factors of the numbers of 8 and 30, we see that the power of 2 is 3, which is the maximum power. The maximum power of 3 is 1, and the maximum power of 5 is 1. With the product of these, we get 120. From above examples, one more important result we obtain that for any two given numbers, A and B, we see that the relation exists over there that product of HCF and LCM of the two given numbers will be equal to the product of the two numbers of which the LCM and HCF has been obtained. You can verify it that the numbers are 2 into 120 is equals to 8 into 30, both are equals to 240. Also, relation exists between HCF and LCM of any two or more numbers. It is that HCF is always a factor of LCM, and LCM is a multiple of the HCF of the same numbers. Here the questions which we have solved, in that 2 is a factor which is HCF. 2 is HCF, which is a factor of 120, which is the LCM. Similarly, 120 is the LCM, which is a multiple of HCF 2. So these type of questions, the relation of HCF and LCM is generally been asked in one mass question. One another important result which is based on fundamental theorem of arithmetic, we are going to discuss it now. The question is that prove that 6 raised to the power n can never end with 0. In another words, this same question may be given that check 6 raised to the power n can end with the digit 0 for any natural number. Here you have to check and here you have to prove. Both are the same type of solution. How we will start it? Its solution is given. If 6 raised to the power n for any n has 0 in the end, then it must have both 2 and 5 as its prime factor using fundamental theorem of arithmetic. As we know that fundamental theorem of arithmetic, that any number ending with 0 must have both 2 and 5 as its prime factors. But what do we observe? We observe that prime factors of 6 has 2 and 3 only. By uniqueness of fundamental theorem of arithmetic, no other factor except 2 and 3 for 6. It means that 6 does not have any other factor apart from 2 and 3. It states by fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Hence, we can say that 6 to the power n can never end with 0 because it does not have both 2 and 5 as its prime factor. Now you are having your homework over here. Find prime factors of 156 and 3825. The second question is HCF and LCM of 336 and 54. And the second question is 12, 15 and 21. Here three numbers are there. And the last question is that prove that 4 raised to the power n can never end with 0.